Good day, everyone. I am Michael Demi Banatia Perocho from the University of Mindanao, and I am here to present our research entitled A Pragmatic Analysis of Mayor Sara Duterte's Public Announcements. Before anything else, allow me to situate first how functional communication is during the pandemic. In light of the COVID-19 or coronavirus disease 2019 pandemic, pandemic information has been vital and communication plays a key factor to help people understand the effects of the virus. And this has been widely evidenced with the way we use communication for us to disseminate important protocols and health restrictions, not only to a specific locality, but also across the entire country. O'Keefe and Reed in 1990 postulate that communication is integral in any public-related communication, such as those that are legal, policy-based, health crisis, and nature. And considering the pandemic we are in now, we really feel the importance of effective communication that is simple and plain, so that the general public could easily understand all of these protocols, mechanisms, and ordinances implemented by the local government units through the direction of the national government. And because there is this necessity for us to fully realize how important language works during this pandemic, we, the researchers, came up with this study with focuses on the following. First one, what locutionary forces are evident in Mayor Sara Duterte's public announcements regarding health protocols? And second, how are politeness strategies utilized in the COVID-19 related public announcements? Our methods are as follows. We use a pragmatic analysis in which we analyze language used based on the context, and that is the pandemic context, and as well as in the context of giving public announcements for information dissemination purposes. We also use the speech acts theory of Searle in 1969 and the politeness theory of Brown and Levinson in 1987. For our corpora, we use 6 purposively selected live broadcast public announcements of Mayor Sara Duterte through the Davao City Disaster Radio, posted on the Facebook page of the city government of Davao. And for us to have equal distribution and sampling from these live broadcast public announcements, we made it sure to get 2 public announcements per quarantine category. That is 2 from ECQ, 2 from GCQ, and also 2 from the MGCQ period. Now, shown on the screen are the results pertaining to the elocutionary forces present in the public announcements or the discourses used by Mayor Sara in disseminating information through radio broadcast. And if you could see here, the 2 most dominant elocutionary forces are assertives and directives, with 13 being the frequency. And in order for us to better understand each of these elocutionary forces, let me define each. First one is assertive. Assertives commit the speaker to believe about something true or not. This elocutionary force pertains to the force being used by a speaker in order to ascertain a specific level of veracity or truth behind a statement. Commissives commit the speaker to some future courses of action, for example, when there is promising or threat being done or offering or refusal. And then we also have declaratives, which effect immediate changes in the institutional state of affairs and which tend to rely on elaborate extra-linguistic institutions. For example, when a speaker pronounces or declares something. And then directives is in which a speaker uses to get someone else to do something. So this is more of requests, questions, commands, orders, and suggestions. And lastly, we have expressives, which state what the speaker feels. For example, when there is this feeling of pleasure, pain, likes or dislikes, apologies, and appreciation. And once again, let me go back to the results. This study reveals that assertives and directives are the 2 dominant locutionary forces in the public announcements made by Sara Duterte for the purpose of disseminating information with regard to the quarantine protocols and other health restrictions. And in order for us to better understand how each of these 2 dominant locutionary forces were used, shown on the screen are some sample excerpts taken from the public announcements. For example, here in the assertive, you could really see that these excerpts show a certain level of veracity or truth behind, because Mayor Sara made it a point to really cite, for example, authorities such as IATF to establish the veracity or truth behind her statements, as mentioned in the public announcements. And also, directives are very much dominant in the public announcements, considering the very nature of communication, and that is to give protocols and other mechanisms to be implemented within Davao City and to be followed by each of the citizens. And another aspect that we look at in this research are the politeness strategies that would help us better understand how Mayor Sara framed the discourses in her public announcements. And there were 4 politeness strategies present in the public announcements. This is also in accordance to the theory of Brown and Levinson regarding politeness strategies. These four are bold on record: positive politeness, negative politeness, and off record. And just very quickly, let me define each one of these. Bold on record is where the strategy is used in an expression. The statement is direct, clear, unambiguous, and concise. In short, there is an element of straightforwardness when this kind of strategy is used in the discourses. Positive politeness, this strategy is used by satisfying the hearer's positive faces. For example, when you compliment a speaker. And then we also have negative politeness. This strategy performs the function of minimizing particular impositions on the hearers. And in here, you use hedges and pessimism in the utterance for you to lessen that level of imposition. And lastly, we have off record. This strategy functions as an indirect communication. Usually this comes in a form of double speak or concealment of the real semantics of discourses. Now, based on the findings, we could see here that bold on record is the most dominant politeness strategy. And if you could see here on the sample excerpts, bold on record is when Mayor Sara became unambiguous, very clear, and straightforward with the statements. And this was very important so that she could really establish the directness and for the public to easily understand the protocols and the health restrictions mentioned in the public announcements. Now, what do the findings suggest? The use of assertive in a public announcement would allow the language consumers to think about veracity and authority. And where there are assertives used in public announcements, then people would really think that there's veracity and authority behind the statements mentioned by a speaker. Utilizing directive in public communication facilitates clear understanding of policies, mechanisms, and methodologies as well during a crisis. Hence, there's participation on the end of the public. And lastly, the use of bold on record becomes useful in ensuring unambiguous communication for the public. And this will easily facilitate comprehension or understanding of the laws being reinforced. Ladies and gentlemen, considering all of these qualities present in the public announcements, let us always be reminded that good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. And during this pandemic, there shall be no room for any ambiguous communication, because if there is any, then the tendency would be the public will find it very difficult to follow all of these mechanisms, policies, ordinances implemented in our respective cities or local government units. Hence, we always gear towards good communication, as this will serve as our bridge between what is confusing and what is clear. Thank you so much for listening to this presentation. I am now open for any questions. Thank you.